Hey, this is Peter from Next on Web. After the slider settings video, today I'm going to show you the most important part of Smart Slider, the slide editor. Let's start from the dashboard. Select the slider you want to edit and choose the slide. Let's start our tour on the top bar. The breadcrumb navigation helps you to navigate back to the dashboard, slider settings, and browse between slides. The preview can be used to view the slider on all kinds of devices, like laptop and mobile. The device selector helps you to design the slide for every device. Layer editing on smaller devices requires extra effort. If you want to dive deeper, click on the info card for the next tutorial video. With the undo and redo buttons, the changes can be reverted. You can go back to the slider settings, where you can reach the WordPress and Joomla admin area. Obviously, with the Save button, you can save the slide. Click on the green button to open the Add panel. This is the place where you can add layers to the slide. For example, heading, image, or video layer. Under the green Add button, you can add the most popular layers. The editor has a ton of keyboard shortcuts, which can speed up the editing. Click on the editor menu to see the full list. For example, in Windows, with Ctrl plus D, in Mac, with Command plus D, you can duplicate a layer. Open the timeline to adjust the layers and play their animations. Editing a layer is very simple. Click on the one you want to change. This opens the layer window, where you can customize the settings. You can move, resize, or even close the layer window when you don't need it. Let's click on the layer again. The button on the top left corner of the layer window opens the layer list, where you can find every layer even if they are not visible. In the layer window, the Content tab contains the basic settings of the layer, for example the text or link of the heading layer. On the Style tab you can find the options, like the color and size of the text. Several options can be adjusted on the slide editor, like the margin. And the Animation tab contains the layer animations we just saw on the timeline. Similarly to the layers, the slide also has options in the layer window. To reach these settings, simply click on the slide label on top of the canvas. The most frequently used setting of a slide is the background, which is on the Style tab. Let's change the background image with the green plus button. I will pick this image about a seashore. Then set the focus point to the most important part of your image. No matter what device is used, this always stays on your slide. If you would like to add a layer, just drag and drop it into the canvas. This time I will choose a button layer. Then we can edit the button in the layer window. In the layer menu you can find the most important actions, like duplicate or delete the selected layer. Let's head back to the Add panel, where you can add entire layouts from the library, not just single layers. The layouts are separated into categories, like theme, testimonial, or feature. Click on the desired layout to load it, but please note, it will override the slide. If you change your mind, use the Undo button to return the slide to the previous state. This is all you need to know about the slide editor. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tips and tutorials. See you later!